So my first experience with Iri-ji was 2014. I don't even know how I found out about it, actually. I think someone just bought me a ticket and I was like, okay, yeah, I'll go along. So I went along and got there late as well. So we just got there for like the dancing bit and it was really good. It was nice to see a lot of young Igbo people in the same room just enjoying a celebration about our culture. So I think that kind of made me want to get more involved in ICSN and find out a bit more about what we do and, you know, how did everyone manage to get in one room together? So that was my experience.
For me, that the yam is a significant part of an Igbo food, actually.
Yeah.
So how do you guys prefer your yam?
Hey.
That's a good one. That's a
I good. Like mine fried with egg.
Yes!
You know what? I like mine with egg as well, but I like it boiled with egg. I like it that nice softness that you can just chop into it.
You,
yeah.
You know when it crunches, that fried. Hey.
You know what? I like mine roasted. Hey. So you roast it whole, then you take the skin off afterwards, and you dip it in ungo, which is a sauce that we have. Yeah. That's how I like it.
You know what? I always wonder how is Iri-ji celebrated in different parts of Igbo land in the different states?
Yeah, I'd really love to know what the history behind it. How did it even come about that they celebrated yam? Yeah, what's it mean?
I would want to know when do they celebrate Iri-ji? When are the festivals?
And for me, I guess the roles for men and women. So in terms of back in the village, you know, what were the roles of the men? You know, was it just, you know, harvesting and the woman's responsibility just cooking? It would just be interesting to actually know the roles, you know, that were played by both men and women in the village during those periods.
So right, was Obia, our resident restaurant at ICSN.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Welcome.
So just to start off, keki me.
Ademuma, go on, Kwan.
Ademuma. Oh, Kabido, Kelafa, and KBC in Anibo.
Ademuma. Avamu Boli Antonin Dubeze, Olinto, Onyo Okozo Kambo, Okozo Ibligada, Onamulon and Nikuno.
Mumma Bum Ketchi, Aguebo. Oli akọ ezemo na agwo egbo I see mwa bo nya mo obia the town next to Oka and ana anum no obosi so automatically abuzi mo no obosi
abambo bc chie ichie okwefuna urmi one of ntaje ino yi local government Anambra State, Nigeria.
Anambra State, oh, Ebensi, yeah, well. Naya, if I need you, be about that, but maka umeme on 22nd of October. And I will for the questions, I enjoy jugging. So, boni genye la ya kaweza fa ogademwa.
Okay. This will be our 18th year of Iri-ji Festival celebrations. So, for us, I think the main question is, what's the history behind it? What does it mean? Why are we celebrating, you know, the New Yam?
New Yam Festival, Iri-ji, is one of the most celebrated, one of the major feasts, if not the most important feasts in Igbo culture. The history is as old as Igbo race itself. Because from the origin of the Igbo race, everything come together that feast. And is a feast of Thanksgiving. Igbo race is actually known for their agricultural expertise. So planting yams and every other thing. So it's a feast to thank God after the harvest. So, and in Igbo land we have the farming season and the harvest season. Yeah. Harvest season, which are the dry season.
Yeah.
So after the harvest, there is nothing again to do. So you now sit back and enjoy your harvest.
Enjoy.
So collectively, people now come together to celebrate their rich harvest, yeah. then thank God for the rich harvest they have got.
Yeah.
IMA event, October 22nd.
Ooh.
2016. So, I chow ikuzin dem mado. Maka the history of Iri-ji, because everybody needs to celebrate here, but through discussions I need to see how everybody ma maka the history of so nyaka nsiki ambido nyawo my first question kefe with the origins and the origins of the Iri-ji and what you know the main importance to Ndibo.
Iri-ji na Igbo bu nnukwu emume. Ololu no n'emume kachasi emume niile a na-eme n'ala Igbo. Ji bụ na kachasi na nni niile a na-akọ akọ n'ubi n'ala Igbo. E ji ji eme ọtụtụ ife. Ma ji bụ nwoke na-akụ ya. E jee n'ubi, ugbo bụ ugbo nwoke. And the main thing dị na ya bụ ji. Nwaanyị nwezi ịgbanyezi akpụ. Ma ọkụ n'ọka mana the main thing na-abụ ji. So na ndị na-akọ ji a na-akpọfa diji anọfafa bụ the men of the society.
Iri-ji n'ala Igbo nwere ibe dị abụọ n'ala Igbo bụ ọdịnala na omenala. Omenala Igbo bụ Iri-ji Igbo niile na-eme. Nna anyị ma na-eme. We make the world one yaka. It was here me and Bembo. We do a kita, Bana koji, na bay. Obulu na jiovu apota. Okay, I'm really jia. Jiovu, until in our law, I may a waji. If waji be one, I may mean ibu no, by naked nechineke. Naked and nanay of a million yike. I wear what Luanya buji. Well, opotia. Ito se bu no microbia mostly naga aga no bibe ne ne jika se jibe ka no ebute onwe yan na po even ndi okenye ndru obia gupute se ji abunne obia kebe ndi obia bebe ndi okenye ndru abwa jina abo jina ato obe se nke munne obe nke munna abezia na na ebe se imena awe abezia ibia meze nyabo iwaji. Iwaji anaga ebuluze aruaji n'oku arusaji n'oku abia menye mmanu nivena wege weji a onye obuna bundi okenya awuri enya bujizi anabi libu ye wofu.
Festive period a ina ekwu maka ya tata sitele na ife afulu n'ebe jide owe bulu na ji nozi onodu keze nni n'ala Igbo. Tupu ka elibe ji n'ala Igbo, a na-agba ofalia. Na-abụ ife oyibo na-akpọzi New Yam Festival. Na-abụ ofala dị n'iche n'iche n'obodo dịgasị iche iche gbaa gburugburu n'ala Igbo. Mana atụmatụ n'usoro esi eme na-eyibe eyibie. And na obodo ọbụla na elinya bụ olili n'ụbọchị afiafa dị azụ.
In regards to the responsibilities during this harvest period from the male and the female, ụmụ nwoke, ụmụ nwanyị, what are their responsibilities during this period?
There are so many responsibilities. The another thing I would have asked is, Igbos don't just plant yams. They plant cocoa yams, they plant corns, they plant so many things. Why then yam? That is where the role comes in. Why yam? Why not cassava? Why not cocoa yam? Why not corn? Why not everything? So if you go back to the Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe, you see that Igbo men are recognized by how big their bams can be. You see, so and because strong men plant yams, and the more you plant, the more you harvest. So having planted yam and harvesting yam is a sign of strength, and the more you have is the measure of your wealth.
Diji niile kọlu ugbo ga-ewepụta ji kachasị ji niile fakọta n'arọ afọ fe weputie na afia for display eba nwe weputeli ona ona duka na zonso onye kokalesin so nke bukalesin ya ka ge wede bi igwe.
You cannot plant yam without yam itself. You can plant cassava with the just cassava stick, but yam, it must be yam itself. And these are done by men. Therefore, there is this, shall I say, cultural role that man is the leader of the family, is the leader of the society, is the leader of the village. Therefore, what the man has is the measure of everything in the village, and that is what they are being celebrated. So coming to the roles, in the family from day one, the women will always do the cooking. That is their role with the daughters, they will be doing the cooking, and the men will be doing every other thing like killing the goats, killing the cows, pounding the yams, getting the yams ready, and other things, fetching the firewood. And you don't just celebrate yam, there is a dancing, there will be the masquerades, and there are visits to all over the place. So culturally, the boys and the men will be taking care of the male dance, the wrestling competition, and the masquerade, the man. Then the girls will be doing their dancing, doing the cooking, and doing the visits and things like that. Other roles is that in that village, within that period, in-laws, relations far and wide use that also to exchange gifts. Like if you have got maybe rich in-law that the daughter is behaving well, to kind of, so is a time maybe the in-law will now come maybe with 2, 3, 4, 10 tubas of yam to the in-law now, the father-in-law now, to say thank you, you gave me your daughter and we have been living very fine and God bless me, so this is what I used to think, you maybe bring yams and things like that. And women also can maybe cook very, very well that day and give to their in-laws, maybe the father-in-law or the mother-in-law, special ones. And this is the time to exchange gifts and things like that. Yeah.
I be kwa na mbosiaga before tupu mbosiaga banya bofala. Ana akwe kwe. And what I may quare by no one mana, Achobazimia no toto, Achotam Rumia, can go soon if a buerque, Anna a cupwe equa mobu gene. No gekita, Anne mezi announcement. E welumoto, we may never announcement, Madame Bubu no gene, more we quake egan. Where's ye, woman walking in no more colobianine? Mbefaga wako, wages so chaba. Bochebe. Okwa gunine dino obodo tumadi na bi igwe ekpochasia edozisie muzo mmili mife nine target mba na agba n'oge afu bu ka ebe nine di ocha we nabata chineke nke na afu maka ji na obe chinko obele na afu maka chi maka ji.
We've kind of talked about some of our favourite moments from Iri-ji. I know that you know you've come to some of the ICSN Iri-ji events. So, what would you say has been your favourite year, and also what's been your favourite part of it as well?
Thank you very much for that question. It's actually a difficult one because I grew up in Igbo land, and growing up, there are things that you don't know that happens and you don't know how it happened because you grew up with it. So you can't remember exactly which one is your favorite one. But personally, or for every boy that grew up in Igbo land, the most important one is that when you grow up, at a certain age, you'll be initiated into the Mau festival or the Mau group, where you'll be given the secret of how, because Mau are there, our ancestors, that normally they come out during that festive period though, so that we enjoy together, we'll be told, or that what happens that they will come out because they were buried living wherever they are living, and during that time they will come out from the ant holes to join us. So when growing up as a boy, you'll be initiated into that secret, how it happens, and you get to know how it happens, that only the men that initiated will know how it happens. So taking part before that time, you'll be running away from masquerade like women. At that point, you wouldn't be considered as a man. So the very first moment, you'll be initiated and you'll be carrying the canes and everything for the masquerade, and they will not flog you, and you'll be allowed to participate. You feel like you have arrived. So that very first moment, the masquerade will see you and we will call your name. And the masquerade, because at that point you'll be recognized by the masquerade, they will call your name and they will recognize your body. So when they greet you, they will call your name, I will say, I'll greet your body. Like Emeka, Aru Emeka Ekenemge, Aru Emeka Ekenemge. That is Emeka's body, I greet you, because they are spirits. You see, you are not in this because they are the spirits. So they are seeing your body, so they greet your body at that point. So when that time you are recognized, you have been initiated, the masquerade will see you and call your name and greet your body and maybe shake your hands, allow you to move. That is the moment of Iri-ji that you will enjoy as a boy anyway. So
oge mpelompe imo na me dulu na be nna m ana emie mgba mgba na eme ezi okpaligwe ana me lute na nne m na nna m dika ndi olu oyibo nopula nop mana mgbe oge anwalu elu Iri-ji na akpunata otutu ndi olu oyibo we tinyezi elu ndi no nuno Mbawa, also lan you, sorry, no macanifian killing our canco. Mom gapo. Umuan, ye gam will go off with each a bupute, and dear one see a sea well, Nata. Wake a mosiana, never the camuan in dinon enugu. I'm all be a branch enugu, I'm all be a branch in Lagos. Branch obuna nebu. Nata, there is spirit of competition only in the game mechalicin. And now, to mgbe I wake you jet out waffle, if awful. Busoma, eh, oh, gang, won your bonaga, mamma, dinu, dree. So, honorable a memorable thing. For me, oh, see, I need a briefing killing in an hour. Me kill. Eh, me was some mongo diana. Me if any.
In terms of culture. Especially as young Igbos in the UK, trying to make sure that we keep this cultural journey alive, not just for us, but for those, our younger ones who are coming up. Because as you know, the language is declining, and there's so many more things that we need to do to make sure that, you know, we stay on top of our culture. So in regards to the Iri-ji, especially in the UK, what do you think needs to be done to engage more young Igbos and to continue to engage people that are already involved?
So it is difficult for our people to go back to the culture. Like I'm looking now, it will be very difficult for me to go to work like this. Unfortunately, it's my... I wouldn't be allowed. I will tell this is not corporate. Yeah. They will tell me, you see? And unfortunately, I can't defend myself that this is my culture. So it becomes more fashionable to dress like corporate, your tie and things like that. The same goes with the music, the same goes with the food, the same goes with the language and every other thing. If we come, maybe if we go out and like my pounded yam, I like to eat it with the offering salad, with my hand and everything. But then it's not fashionable. So people would like to use their forks and things like that. So the thing is that people should be encouraged to be bold enough as far as the culture is concerned. When we come to the culture, let's try and do, at least learn what our people do. You can use your fork and knife and every other thing, but on the celebration of that, we eat our pounded yam with our hands. And again, coming to this place, we are asked to learn the language, learn life in UK. We all did that and pass and all those things. So our people should also be encouraged to learn that, learn the accent. You mustn't use it to everybody, but when we come together as a group, we use that. So that encouragement, unfortunately, there is no motivation, because there is motivation when I'm learning English. I know that I'm learning English and we use it to survive. I use it to get job. I use it to prosper in life. But somebody be like, what do I do with Igbo? And nobody pays you for learning it. Nobody. does anything. It's just personal conviction. So the only thing we can do is to encourage our young ones. The reward is that their identity is maintained, because whether you like it or not, you need that identity. So that alone is what is still encouraging me, because when I came in, I wouldn't even know that I would meet something like that. But when I met them, I was happy to associate with my people, feel at home. This is the only place you can feel at home. There is what they used to say in Igbo land, proverb, I will say it in Igbo, then I translate. Obosi nwanne oyana. What does that mean? On the day you will need your brother, the friendship will stop. What it means is that no matter how good your friend can be to you, it cannot substitute for your brother. I don't know if you get that. So on that day you will need your brother, friendship will stop. So what it means is that on a day you will need your identity, whatever qualification, whatever money, whatever association you have gathered over the time will stop, because you need my identity. This is who I am, this is where I come from, this is where my ancestors come from. And that is all we need to do. Thank you.
Biwezilezi makana su Igbo anyi was a wanted move completely after our own generation. Oh yeah, they very hard makana so so ndi Igbo no buda bundi mu bana na amuru Igbo ona di very very rare ki ya bunyi Igbo mu na su Igbo jichinike o ya balunu chinike igozunu ndi na ndi many organize mata ni ba biwe na iba na eme.
During the period.
Yeah.
You go that small sample.
So many groups, umu abogo, mweke chiko begu nkefa. Ane emere ene gai. Umu abogo, eki kefa na adikuwa attractive, makana faga abwa, mbule mbwa na abwaga sinokpa, ana akbo, ijele. Yeah? Faga abwe anokpa. Etuwe sine zogale, umenye jinjinjim. Ane yijigida, nuku. Yeah? Etuwe sine megele arote pia pia. Straight away. So, ana... Nelisie so many things. Ni na nyabo emume.
Wow. Yes. So, thank you for
exactly.
Thank you very much for bringing this. Like you see, this is one of those things we said earlier. This is not exactly how it is,
yeah.
But good enough. It can substitute for what you want. So we should know that in Iri-ji Festival. It is roasted yam with red oil and the opaka oil bean, then okazu and the okazu and all those leaves, you see. But unfortunately, we are in London and we have to improvise. The girls will accept it.
Amen. And there was one other thing you said before as well, is that we, you know, people come together and eat together as well, and we eat with our hands.
Yes.
So I appreciate this will be one of those moments that we're going to eat with our hands.
Yes. And
yeah, together.
Yes, the truth is that in those days back home,
mm-hmm.
we don't know about jams. we believe, just the same thing we're talking about, the jams that can only get the weak ones, that the strong men, like we say in our, what they say, jams hasn't got any authority in him, strong Igbo man's body. Because you are strong enough, you can deal with all those things. But we know now that they're all true. So at least now we wash our hands, then we go for this. Mm-hmm. And we'll enjoy it. So,
Imanaineme Iri-ji on October 22nd. I name we invite, hopefully, Iyengwe Tamiya, Iri-ji Webia, support Wi-Fi name. So hopefully, our invitation
can be invitation, yeah, no one ma on a queer naha Jesus. So,
a quick abian on your line.
My ben on your own.
I want to just thank ICSN and thank all of you for all the effort, all the time you're spending, because I've worked for ICSN before and I'm sure that it's 100% voluntary work. Nobody pays for your time, nobody gives you transport, nobody gives you anything, and your family responsibility is still there. And that is why some of us that got more responsibility, we stop. It looks as if we stop, but if you cannot cope with the responsibility. So I encourage you, and I believe that the reward is there. Mm-hmm. As Igbos, we believe that our ancestors are watching, mm-hmm. and definitely they're gonna reward each and every one of us.
So now you know, guys, the history behind Iri-ji, how it's celebrated in the different states, what it's like, where it came from, the roles. We would love you guys to join us on the day.
ICSN's Iri-ji is going to be this year on October 22nd, 2016, Oasis Banqueting Suite in Barking. That's Thames Road, and it's going to be from 6 p.m. until late.
Yeah, what to expect? We're going to have a live band, masquerade performances, we're going to have Ego Oganiri performing once again, food, dance. I'm really excited.
And tickets are out now. You can still get your tickets. So if you're an ICSN member, at this point now tickets are £20. And if you're a non-member, it's £22.50. For children up until what age?
I think it's 12.
Yep, it's £10. And then anyone underneath that, it's free entry. So make sure you get your tickets in advance, guys.
Make sure you come. Traditional attire. Yes. We want to see your traditional wear.
Yes, it's got to be done. Right, well, we'll see you guys. So make sure you get your tickets. If you see an exec around, they'll have paper tickets as well. So yeah, we look forward to seeing you guys.
What's the website for them?
Website is www.icsn.co.uk.
See you on the 22nd.
Yeah,
see you guys. See you at Iri-ji.
IQ Express offers you the best service in air cargo, ocean freight and door-to-door services to Nigeria and Africa from the UK, USA, Dubai or China.
IQ Express is not an option when it comes to cargo, freights and shipping. It's simply a must.
We handle all sorts of shipping needs. Our excellent five-star service ensures your peace of mind. Call us now or visit our website to see how we can help.